Good morning and welcome to the Mac. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Jenna Yost and I will be your host for the service. Our goal with this service is really quite simple. It's to know Christ and to make Christ known. Now the service is designed to equip and inspire adults to live life as their Heavenly Father designed it to be lived. So no matter what season of life you're in or where you are in your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. So let's go ahead and introduce our worship leaders. Leading our worship service is Ken Soltis. And delivering the message today is Richard Rivera. Now, about Children's Church, all you parents listen up if you want to see your children again. When you see this slide on the screen, the children can go out this door where the adult leaders will be waiting to take them to Children's Church. Each week, your children will participate in an engaging large group gathering for worship and Bible teaching. And after the service, please pick up your children in the Bray Chapel, which is right past the information desk. Now at 9:30 every Sunday morning, we will gather downstairs in the MAC for coffee, pastries, and fellowship. Then everyone can head out to Bible studies from there, or you can just hang out and get to know other people. So let's get a sneak peek into the coming weeks. January is Decaffeinated Christianity Month. You know, the kind of Christianity that doesn't keep you awake at night. There's a form of decaffeinated Christianity in our culture, and we buy into it more than we might think. We go through the form of what it means to be a Christian, but we're a little afraid to go out on the edge because we're afraid somebody might think we're a Bible thumper. So we have decaffeinated our Christian faith, we've cut down the edges, we've smoothed off the places where it has touched our lives, then we wonder why there's no power in it. So trust me, you don't want to miss this series. So I want to leave you with a short story that should better explain our mission here. Several years ago, executives at Sears were facing a marketing challenge. Plenty of women were shopping at Sears for stuff like hardware and tools and plumbing fixtures, but the women were avoiding the women's department. But Sears executives were convinced that if women only knew about the new line of clothing they had for sale, they would become customers of that department too. But how could they promote the clothing in such a way that it would connect with these customers? So marketing experts, they studied the situation, they hammered out a marketing strategy, and they developed an advertising campaign called Come See the Softer Side of Sears. They developed a two-page magazine ad. One side of the page showed an automotive battery. The other side showed a woman wearing a very dramatic evening dress. The headline quotes the woman as saying, "I came in for a diehard and left with something dropped dead." So Sears analyzed all the demographic information. They placed the ad in particular publications. Then they looked at the viewing habits of women in the age range that they wanted to reach. They even decided to place 30 and 60 second TV commercials on the annual Emmy Awards show. In all, Sears spent $40 million on this marketing campaign. And guess what? It worked. Okay, so why am I giving Sears a free 60 second commercial? It's because of a passage of scripture. When Jesus walked this earth, he taught that citizenship in God's kingdom is open to anybody who sincerely seeks it. Now, this was an incredible message to the people. What he was saying is that the very individuals who thought there was no way they could be good enough to enter into heaven, that they could get in not on the basis of their goodness, but on the basis of his goodness. So Jesus wanted that life-changing message to be communicated far beyond the side of that hill 2,000 years ago. He wanted people all over the globe to find out about it. Because surely when people find out that God has flung open the doors of his kingdom, they're going to respond in droves. So he needed, to put it bluntly, a marketing strategy. So guess what his marketing strategy is? You. You're it. Jesus said that he doesn't need to buy ads in the Wall Street Journal. He doesn't need to buy ads in the AJC. And he doesn't need to buy commercial time during the Super Bowl because he has you. You're his plan. Jesus said, "My plan A is you. My plan B, yeah, that's also you. Plan C, yeah, I got one. It's you. Know Christ and make Christ known. Welcome to the Mac."